Phil Ivey was born on February 1, 1977 in Riverside, California. When he was just 3 months old, his family moved to Roselle in New Jersey. This small suburban town is where Phil Ivey would spend the bulk of his childhood. Ivey's love of poker started early. He had his grandfather to thank for introducing him to the game at the young age of 8. Ivey and his grandfather would spend countless hours playing 5-card stud together, sometimes putting a few pennies up for stakes. Phil mastered the game quickly and was soon developing his own winning strategies for it. His grandfather saw his natural talent for the game and was the first one to point out his potential to go pro. It would take Ivey many hours of hard work and dedication in order to hone his poker skills. When he was about 16 years old, he would regularly participate in a weekly poker game that would take place at one of his friend's house. He often won, but not much money was ever at stake. Ivey soon joined a telemarketing firm based in New Jersey. As Phil Ivey grew older, his love for poker never subsided. He longed to play poker at the casinos of Atlantic City, but he would not be legally able to enter until he turned 21. So what did he do? Well, he created a fake ID. He would be known for years as Jerome Graham. He moved to Atlantic City and regularly put in 15 plus hours a day, fine-tuning his skills and trying out various strategies. He quickly earned the name No Home Jerome. There are several conflicting stories regarding the meaning of the No Home Jerome moniker Ivey was tagged with by other Atlantic City poker players. And while many believe it's a testament to the amount of time he spent playing poker in the casinos, the true meaning behind the name is probably far less romantic. According to the most credible sources, the nickname came about thanks to Ivey missing the last bus home several times and having to sleep on the Atlantic City beach. Other stories list the nickname's creation coming from Ivey's propensity to go broke when he started playing poker and being homeless. This version also had him sleeping on the beaches. The true origin of the No Home Jerome moniker is likely an amalgamation of all these stories. Slowly but surely, his game strategy improved. At the age of 20, when he went pro, he realized he was still no match for more seasoned players like Barry Greenstein and Daniel Negreanu, who believed him to be an easy opponent because of his habit of playing too loose and too many hands. However, as time is witness, Phil Ivey soon worked out his weakness and managed to master each of them. Once Phil Ivey was of legal playing age, Barry Greenstein and Daniel Negreanu, amazing professional poker players in their own right, took Ivey under their wings. They gave him tips on how to improve his gaming style. Ivey started entering as many tournaments as he could. The first tournament he ever won was the Trops Customer Appreciation Invitational Tournament in Atlantic City, and he instantly won $1,000 and was hooked on tournament play. Just a couple of years later, he would enter his first WSOP event, where he was able to place first at the Pot Limit Omaha event. This was special because not only did he walk away from the competition with $195,000 in his pocket, but he won his first WSOP gold bracelet and was the first player to beat Amarillo Slim in the final table of the WSOP. More importantly than the money though, it brought Ivey the confidence he needed to pursue poker as a career. Since then, Phil Ivey had added 9 more WSOP bracelets to his collection for a grand total of 10 bracelets. Not many people can say they have won 10 WSOP gold bracelets, and even fewer people can say that they have won 3 bracelets in the same year. Phil Ivey's poker accomplishments aren't limited to the World Series of Poker. In 2005, he walked away with $1 million after winning the Monte Carlo Millions tournament. This was the first poker tournament ever held at the gorgeous Casino de Monte Carlo, and Ivey was more than happy to be a part of it. Ivey believes the World Poker Tour is worth traveling for. He has been participating in the WPT almost as long as he has been participating in the WSOP. He has found great success there. One of his most noteworthy accomplishments was taking first place in the No Limit Hold'em Championship in 2008. He took down Phil Hellmuth and other great poker players, walking away with $1.5 million in the process and his first ever WPT title. In 2012, he traveled down under to participate in the Aussie Millions. He played in a number of events there, but was most successful during the No Limit Hold'em $250,000 challenge. In that game, he found himself head-to-head against Patrick Antonius, an excellent poker player who he eventually would become good friends with. That victory brought him a cool $2 million. 2 years later in 2014, he returned to Australia to compete in the same event. Phil Ivey took first place in the Aussie Millions Poker Championship in Melbourne, Australia. The first year, he won $3.5 million and competed against 30 contestants, while in the second year, he won $1.7 million competing against 25 contestants. At the World Poker Tour National in the Philippines in 2016, Phil won a cash prize of $656,000 when he came in fifth. Also, the Triton Super High Roller Series has been an interesting event for Ivey, with the first and third place finish only a few days apart in 2018 in Montenegro for a combined prize of $2.2 million. When visiting the Party Poker Millions in Sochi in 2020, Phil Ivey racked up three cashes, a seventh and a second place finish, and a win for a total of $1.5 million. For over 15 years, Phil Ivey has been winning some of the planet's biggest poker games. He's a regular at the Las Vegas Bellagio, most often participating in the $4,000, $8,000 stake mixed cash games. In addition, he was a critical player with The Corporation, a team of high-stakes professionals who joined forces to take on Andy Beal at a heads-up limit hold'em game for enormous sums of money. When The Corporation was down $10 million to Beal, Phil Ivey stepped up his game, winning $16.6 million from the Texan over 3 days during a heads-up match at the Wynn Resort. The stakes were $25,50 and $50,100,000. This was a sweet revenge after Beal had beaten The Corporation out of $13 million earlier that month. According to rumors, Ivey has also taken some significant sums of cash from Chinese businessmen who he has been playing in high-stakes cash games in Macau since 2010. Before 2011, Phil Ivey was the biggest online cash game winner ever. He earned a total of $19.2 million from 2007 to 2011 playing cash games on Full Tilt Poker. After 2011 though, Phil Ivey has a less than stellar record. Using the name Polarizing on Full Tilt Poker, Ivey is down almost $6.3 million on the 217,000 hands played from December 2012 to August of 2015, and using the name Raise Once on PokerStars, he appears to be down $2.5 million on 200,000 hands played during the same period. In 2017, word got out that Phil Ivey had made the cut for the Poker Hall of Fame. Freshly turned 40, this was the first year Phil Ivey was eligible for membership. Chances of getting inducted into the Poker Hall of Fame in your first year of being featured on the finalist list are slim to none. But this was Phil Ivey we were talking about. He was proud when it was announced that he, alongside David Ulliott, would be the winners that year. Until April 2011, Phil Ivey received $920,000 per month for his collaboration with Full Tilt Poker, where he was a member of the original design team. After Black Friday, he filed a lawsuit against Full Tilt Poker in order to help recover funds lost by US players during the company's actions. He even sat out of the 2011 WSOP main event in recognition of the players who lost money because of Full Tilt. When the company reopened, he began playing under the username Polarizing. Phil Ivey was also involved in a high-profile litigation in 2012. After playing Punto Banco for two nights at Mayfair Club, Crockford's Casino in London and winning $12 million, Ivey ended up suing the casino for not paying him. The casino responded by saying that they refused to pay Ivey because he used a trick called edge sorting. Ivey even admitted as much, claiming that he asked the dealer to rotate the cards 180 degrees in order to exploit asymmetrical pattern differences on the cards, and it was the casino's fault that he could do that since they used flawed cards and rotated them according to his request. Although he lost the court case, he appealed to the court with the highest jurisdiction in the country, the UK Supreme Court, who stated in late 2017 that Ivey's actions were indeed considered as cheating. In 2014, the Borgata Casino filed a $9.6 million lawsuit against Phil Ivey over cheating, claiming that he exploited playing cards manufacturing laws over four sessions in 2012. Borgata went on to win the case, and a US court ordered Ivey to repay a total of $10 million. The long-running legal war has reportedly reached an agreement to settle its six-year case. While the terms and amount for the settlement was not disclosed, the awaited decision is unsurprising, as per gaming attorney Mac Verstanding. Also, nearly 9 years after its inception, the Ivey Room at the Aria Resort and Casino was no more. After the Borgata scandal, given that the Borgata is owned by MGM, who also owns the Aria, the name on the Ivey's Room at the Aria was changed to Table 1. When Phil Ivey was in high school, he started dating a girl named Lucita. Anytime Ivey wasn't playing poker, he was spending time with her. Young and in love, Ivey and Lucita decided to tie the knot. But a few years into their marriage, they both decided they wanted different things in life. Phil Ivey is a living proof that marrying your high school sweetheart rarely works. The divorce was rough. Lucita and her lawyer worked hard to make sure she could get as much money out of the lawsuit as possible. She ended up receiving $180,000 a month in alimony and approximately $2.2 million worth of jewelry and designer purses. Currently, Phil Ivey is enjoying a long-term relationship with his girlfriend, Nelly Garcia. Phil Ivey has also founded two companies, both based on poker. The first is Ivey Poker. This was a play-for-free poker app that was established in 2012 to allow users to compete against pros like Phil Ivey. The second is Ivey League, which is a poker trading site founded in 2014. In 2015, Chrysler created a 60-second commercial that featured a myriad of hardworking Americans who are responsible for their own success. This was to promote their latest Chrysler 300. Ivey felt privileged to be among the selected few who were chosen to make an appearance on it. Later that same year, Chrysler made another commercial to promote the same vehicle, this time featuring Phil Ivey exclusively. This marks one of the first times a professional player received mainstream media recognition. In September of 2019, an interesting story emerged when Daniel Cates and Elijah Trencher filed a legal objection to Borgata's seizure of Phil Ivey's WSOP Poker Players Championship winnings. They claimed that they had a staking deal which involved paying 100% of Ivey's buy-in, and as such, a significant portion of his winnings belonged to them. The only realistic reason Phil Ivey would sell 100% of his action is that he has run out of money. According to CelebrityNetWorth.com, Phil Ivey is worth $100 million, but these recent developments suggest this figure could be, in fact, zero. No one knows for sure if these figures are correct except Phil Ivey and his accountant. Ivey is also an avid sports fan. He's particularly fond of the LA Lakers, Houston Rockets, and Buffalo Bills, and he's regularly seen wearing basketball jerseys representing a variety of teams. When he's not working or watching sports, Ivey enjoys playing video games, prop betting, and golf. He also placed third in the inaugural World Series of Golf, which is why some people call him the Tiger Woods of poker. Phil Ivey is a unique character in the field of poker. He had experienced a lot of big wins as well as huge losses at the table, but he's always being matured about whatever the game throws at him. He will forever be one of the greatest poker players of all time. This video is powered by Bluff the Spot, the best place to learn how to win at poker from actual high-stake coaches like MMA Sherdog. Check the link in the description. And if you like this video, leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.